And back now at the Olympic Stadium, the Telstra Stadium. We're waiting for the Penrith Panthers and the New Zealand Warriors to make their entry onto the ground for the second preliminary final. And of course, the immediate entry into the grand final to play the Sydney Roosters victors last night in what was a tremendous win for them against the Canterbury Bulldogs. Reece Wethers' father in the crowd, forming part of a crowd that I think is a bit disappointing when you compare it with that that was attracted by the New Zealand Warriors against Canberra last weekend. But then again, we're in a much bigger house, aren't we? Seat something like 80,000 people, Telstra Stadium, and there are some very congested parts of the stadium, but then again, plenty of empty seating as well. Now, here they come, the Warriors looking to go to their second grand final consecutively. And that's going to be a tremendous boost to them, I'm sure, here playing at Telstra Stadium today. The fact they've been here before, and particularly playing in daylight hours, they've won 9 out of 11 daytime games this year. And 10 members of last year's grand final team is in the 17 today. Clinton Torpy, was interesting to hear Matthew Johns rating him as the number one centre in the game today. That mightn't sit well with some, but I'll tell you what, I don't disagree. Logan Swan is off to England. He'll join up with Wigan or Bradford. And this could be his last match in Warriors colours. Beautiful day, and we love you, Eric. Thank you for the freebies, bro. Why not? This is their second weekend of the football, the Kiwis, many of them, for absolutely nothing. Thank you to Eric Watson, the owner of the New Zealand Warriors. One of God's own days here in Sydney. It really is. There's not a cloud in the sky as the Penrith Panthers come out and onto a stadium that I've described that is very familiar, I suppose, to the Warriors in many ways. But as far as Penrith's concerned, they haven't played at Telstra since February 2001. And 9 of the players in the squad of 17 have not played here. Now, just how important that is, I don't quite know. But I guess that's one of the reasons why their coach sent them out to warm up on the stadium prior to kickoff today. The footy show's Player of the Year, Craig Gow. And an absolute certainty for the Kangaroo Tour if he remains injury-free.
And Joe Nullarbor, who limped off very badly against Brisbane a fortnight back. He did play for the Warriors. Fullback centre. He's going to greener pastures, and how green have they turned? There's John Lang, so the footy show's coach of the year, sitting down for another roller coaster afternoon.
That microphone that wraps around in front of his mouth, John has eaten 5 of them this year. He does really get wrapped up in his football. Penrith are going to run towards the southern end.
You right, Paddy? Okay, boys.
And there's the kickoff under Tim Mander. And first receipt of the ball down in the southeastern corner for the Warriors, 10 metres out from their own line as it comes across and through Guttenbeel originally. And Jerry CUCU will play the ball for the second time in the afternoon here for the Warriors. We're coming to you live this afternoon. And these circumstances, special circumstances this year, really a great season. With enormous television ratings last night. Thank you for watching us. As it's played then by Guttenbeel, and it's gone now to Villasanti. And he will play the ball just outside the 30-metre line. And gets up and a little bit stunned by the tackle. Now they go across for the first of the kicks in the game. It bounces around. It bubbles around, to use a Phil Gouldism. And it's Reece Wesser with the ball. And he's put away by Monty Beetham in conjunction there with Guttenbeel, 35 out from the Panthers' line for Luke Lewis now. The winger tackled in the first penalty of the game.
Yes, it's a 10-metre penalty. The Warriors showing too much enthusiasm. Well inside the 10. When they had the football, it was interesting to see inside their own 20. They were going 2 passes wide. They wanted to get a little bit wider for the play of the ball. And once outside the 20, and they went through the man coming straight off the dummy half.
It's a very good kick by Gower. He's found touch for them. Down on the Warriors 20-metre line. Pritis taking the tap. Lang it was who gave him a dummy decoy. And then it's with Nullarbor with the brown hair today. As Pritis goes to Clinton, Clinton goes hard. And he's pulled down about 8 metres away from the Warriors line. A real test here early for the New Zealanders as Campbell picks up Pulitua. And Tony Pulitura is tackled a few metres away from the corner post. Over on the sunny side of the ground. Now it's away for Campbell to go to Gower. Gower to go to Sattler. The runaround back for Gower. Oh, it came off the fingertips of Wesser. It's gone loose. It's gone all over the place. And Manda will order knock-ons against both and put a scrum down.
They're doing what he does so well. Craig Gower. The pass wasn't meant for Reece Wesser. He was looking to go wider. On the other side of the coin, the Warriors will be very happy with their online defence early in the game. Famawuna getting a tap on the head from Arwen Guttenberg.
So Stacey Jones working the scrum. We know that he hasn't been fully fit, but he's been getting through the game satisfactorily. But I don't know that you can go into grand finals less than 100% fit or less than 90% fit. And Stacey Jones, it'll be interesting to watch him today, particularly his action, his freedom. Logan Swan it was who played that ball, then from Villasanti, now across to CUCU as we go to Andrew Voss on the sideline.
And Ray, conditions a bit like last night, to be quite honest. Very gusty, more an advantage for Penrith in this first 40 minutes. Interesting, too, to hear what Tim Mander said to the two captains at the toss. Two things he would be strict on today. One was the markers not standing square. The other one was time wasters. He doesn't want players questioning his decisions, delaying play.
Jones with that kick, it bounces up beautifully for Rooney, a high kick, but that didn't worry Luke Rooney. He's about 6'6", and he comes back towards halfway.
Ray, as you mentioned earlier, Richard Villasanti is still far from 100% out there, finding it hard to get involved. He's been put back on his heels early in this match.
That's Preston Campbell, former Dally M Player of the Year.
He's hanging on.
5 metres into Warriors territory then, as Martin Lang, the son of the coach, goes up to the 40-metre line, right up the middle. Plays it back quickly for Prudis. He gives a little handoff then for Joe Nullivau. And Nullivau, who represented the Kiwis this year, was able to get the ball away. And this is Torpy with the number four on his back.
Tackle 20 metres
out from the line. Good day for Nullivau and Pulitua to impress Daniel Anderson. Here's Campbell with a weaving run. And pulled down 10 metres out. This time by Villasanti. And Campbell plays it back. And Prudis gives it away. And Gower gives the pass. It's gone loose and it's picked up by Fafili. Put to ground by Rooney on the far side of the ground, but they really had the numbers over there, Penrith, and something could have really come out of that for them.
Yeah, they're really up for this one, the Panthers. My concern was that they'd be a little bit slow to start, having waited around for a couple of weeks looking forward to this big game, but they've tried very, very hard to get on the front foot early. Big charges from their forwards, couple of offloads, going wide when they get the opportunity. So they're here to play, the Panthers, you can guarantee that.
Played back for Beetham, and Beetham comes across for Jones, and Jones puts the kick in, and now it's with Rooney, and he comes away off his 20 metre line. And now for Girdler.
Yeah, Luke Rooney a little bit pained out of that tackle as well. Some heavy contact out there, we expected it. There are a few players already early in this game just feeling the effects as Luke Prittis slips over, comes back, and then runs into Suyu before offloading to Campbell.
Campbell away from Torpy. And eventually they're able to bring the little fellow to a rest.
Back up.
Right on the halfway line now, Penrith, with Martin Lang going for full petrol, and he's wrapped up by Suyu. Together with Guttenbeel, they make the tackle. Then it goes from Nullivau to Gower's boot and on. Very big clash of bodies there between Villasanti and Gower as the ball goes in touch and go.
Well, don't anyone ever doubt the toughness of Craig Gower. Look at that. He knew Villasanti was coming. He concentrated on his kick and he bounces straight up after the contact. Sattler has something to say to Villasanti. But Gower, how tough is he?
So this is Torpy with the ball now. My apologies to young Paul Fatawira there earlier, but as we find the New Zealanders now out to their 40-metre line through Webb getting his, I think, first touch of the game. Torpy's close to the sideline. Nullivau made the tackle just inside the touchline. Melly is the dummy half, and now it's gone away to Famawina, and Campbell and Sattler combined to bring him down. Beetham sneaks out from dummy half, picks up a running Guttenbeel. And he will play the ball 35 metres out now from the Panthers' line. They haven't really been down here. They've had no scent at all of a chance to really hit them inside their red zone. Here's Rooney now.
But it's been a very steady progression here for the Warriors. They've had four kicks, five kicks. The first one, they kicked to the opposition 40, then to the opposition 30, then to the opposition 20, and now this kick, they've kicked it down to the opposition 10. So they're gradually working their way up the park.
Played by Sattler, back on inside the 20-metre line, and this is Lang, who's met by Beetham, and Logan Swan put on his back. And Gower goes over to Girdler. Girdler finds an opening. Girdler sprints hard down the ground, down to the 30-metre line. New Zealand's in.
Last tackle. Last one.
Last tackle indicated by Tim Mander. For Gower to kick to this corner. He'll be looking for Luke Lewis. Lewis then will have the jump. He was in the field of play and batted it back in. That's play on for the Warriors. Torpy for foul Mawina, and he's outside the 20-metre line.
Tackled
about 22 metres outside the New Zealand line at the moment as they run away from the southern end.
Lovely break made by Penrith, getting Ryan Girdler into open spaces. And then the Warriors did well to defend it. They had defenders go to support players to make sure they were covered, allowing Webb to take the centre. Here's Villasanti warming to the task, 45 out from his own line.
Vinny Anderson throwing one of those lollipop passes that takes so long to find his target. And then CU unloads. And it's gone from Stacey Jones to a support player a couple of metres short of the halfway. It was ordinary play, though, I've got to say. And now Torpy adds to the problem. And so there's going to be a turnover because I think that was the last tackle. It was.
It was also a chance, Ray. They had Preston Campbell isolated on the short side. The winger had gone back. Torpy, he wanted to get it. Draw Campbell and put Melly away.
Arwen, hold.
Joining us on the sideline today, Matthew Johns.
Yeah, just keep an eye on, boys, how Penrith structured their defence under pressure today. When you come up against Stacey Jones, you learn that most of the time when he does go the line, he likes to play short. Canberra were punished on two or three occasions last week for sliding on their try line. Look for the Panthers to get up quick and close in with their defence today.
Here's Sattler, and then to Pritis, and now to Gower. Gower's inside the 30. He's done better than that. He's reached the 20-metre line. And really stretched there, Anderson and CU. Girdler with a nice kick. Chance for the Panthers. Webb might have won the race.
He's won it all right. And he's done it in cool fashion. Good quick play of the ball. Ryan Girdler, the left foot stabbed through. And just watch Brent Webb. He just comes across. No panic. Snuffs out the attack. Luke Prentice leading the charge. We have a line drop out to restart. Some good pressure here from the Panthers in the last few minutes.
And Ryan Girdler applauding there his teammates for the good break inside. And the experienced man, Gower, made the break. Quick play, the ball onto Girdler. No hesitation. Finals football means nothing to experienced players. He immediately put it on the toe. And Luke Prentice, another experienced campaigner, was there for the chase. That's the sort of leadership you're looking for early in a final.
So Clinton on the carry back of the line dropout, which was taken by Villasanti. He's a man for all seasons, Richard Villasanti. He's in there driving in that tackle as well. With Logan Swan, they're just inside the 30. It's been all Panthers as far as territory and possession is concerned. Now Pulatua, and they're only 15 metres away from the line. Girdler tries to do something up the middle.
That's four.
He runs into Guttenbeel. He plays it back for Pritis, and Gower's 9 metres out. So is Campbell, so is Fatawira. Lewis for the corner, gets it over. Lewis has scored the first try of the day. No examination from the video referee. Tim Mander points to the spot, 4-0 after 11.
Finally turned pressure into points, and I've got to say it's a bad route here from the winger, Francis Melly. They come wide. Stacey Jones was looking to slide as we freeze it there. This man has come in, and he wants to keep coming in, and that allows a corridor down the side. Play continues. He had to slide with Stacey Jones, but Melly came in. Jones started to slide. Melly kept going in. Luke Lewis almost unopposed, despite the halfback's attention.
Beautiful hands here by Fatawira. Campbell must have thought about the long ball directly to Lewis on the wing, but instead he went through the hands, and Fatawira here, quick hands, watch, bang. That's the one that beats Mealy. Mealy had read the play right. Lewis had to stand his ground and wait for the ball. Stacey Jones couldn't hold him up, and he reaches it out and puts it down in the corner. Good finishing effort there by the winger. At this stage, Lewis didn't know if he was going to get the ball off Preston Campbell or off Fatawira, so he just bided his time. Very cool play from a young player. Great hands by Fatawira.
And isn't he a good finisher? 18 for the season. Would not be a shock to see him named in a touring squad at the end of the year. Ryan Girdler. Well, this is one advantage they have over their opposition, the goal-kicking department. Warriors have used 8 and still kick under 60%. This man kicking over 70.
22 metres out from the touchline for Ryan Girdler. It's on its way. He's pulled it around. So no addition. Just the try for Luke Lewis. And 4-0 in favour of the Panthers. Girdler missing the conversion. Andrew Voss.
And Ray, 13 minutes in, and chalk up another try for the Panthers. Dynamic trio. What about the three at the back? Wesser, Lewis, Rooney. Between them now, 57 tries this season. That the 18th try for Luke Lewis. Luke Rooney's got 15. And, of course, Reece Wesser, number one try scorer in the game with 24. What an arsenal of attack they have in the 3 men at the back.
Telecast coming to you live this afternoon from Telstra Stadium. As Tony Pulotua comes charging back at the New Zealanders, they wrap him up. Three of them in combination inside the 20-metre line. Now for his second-row partner, Joe Nullivar. Put the ball away for Luke Prittis to make some more ground. They're out to the 30-metre line now, Penrith. So coming out of their own area quite simply. Goodenbeale, 10 tackles for the game. Penalty goes Penrith.
As Monty Beacon questions the referee, this is uncharted waters for the Penrith team in recent performances to find themselves in front after 13, 14 minutes. Well behind against Parramatta, also Brisbane.
Gower finding the line about 7 metres short of halfway, and this is a strong run by Pulotua that sees him go through a couple of tackles. See you, and Goodenbeale were both beaten badly. Logan Swan is the man that makes the tackle. They're 30 metres out from the Warriors' line. That was shocking defence by a couple of the forwards for the New Zealand side. Here's Fatawira with the ball. 18 metres out from the line. Girdler a dummy half. It's gone for Nullivar to run again. It's Goodenbeale and See you. 10 metres from the line again now as Prittis finds Gower. Gower gets Lang running a decoy. Long ball out to Farfini. The New Zealanders with the ball. And off the hook just for the moment.
Yeah, you could see Luke Rooney on the outside of Henry Farfili, but physically just couldn't get the ball there. Did well for Farfili to get himself in the way. Found Mawina now.
On four.
See the first man to come off for the Warriors. And that's Corpu, who's taken his place.
Last one!
Webber dummy half, and then Jones, the first receiver, and he kicks straight to Rooney, back on his own 20-metre line. So the Panthers' young winger is tackled now, just outside the 30, over on the eastern side of the ground.
Gee whiz, the Panthers' wingers are dropping back deep and early in the tackle count, looking for that Jones kick. I wouldn't be surprised if they run the ball late in the tackle count. As this half wears on, they already dropped one down the short side when running it on tackle five was an option. The Panthers wingers have got to be careful they don't go back too early.
Clinton now running straight at Logan Swan and Corpu with Beetham. Beetham, of course, was kept out of the festivities last year with that broken leg. Here's Gower making a clean break, picking up Wesser. Wesser finds Sattler. Sattler's not held. Gives it back to Wesser, and Wesser is tackled 5 metres out on the fifth tackle. Gower looks for a running Joe Nullivar, and he's held. Gee, that was great defence online from New Zealand.
Yeah, how did they stop Nullivar there? They had numbers to the right-hand side. Gower, the little jink, staggered defence, Villasanti and Goodenbeale. And Scott Sattler striding out. And the next play, they really did look like scoring down the right-hand side, but fortunately for them, a relieving penalty as Mr. Wesser looks on.
Jones taking the kick for line. I don't think he found as much territory as he was aiming to. Richard Villasanti is tackled on the 30-metre line, and Torpy rather clumsily got the ball away for foul. Molina. They haven't had much ball down in Penrith territory. This has been very much the pattern of all of our finals. The team really dominating in possession and territory early. Jones is with the ball now.
That's four dominant. Hold.
Play back for Webb, and Webb is one of the players that really can crack you open. And when he comes into dummy half, he can be very, very dangerous as Jones tries to put a little grubber in behind. And Rooney read it and came up and took the tackle 17 metres away from the Penrith line. Penrith leading 4-0. With a try scored by Luke Lewis down the right side. Girdler's been inspirational for Penrith. Not only that, he's been running around, G'ing them up, patting them on the back, talking to them, knowing that he is one of those players that has got the experience of big-time football. Several of them haven't. Pritis now finding Gower. Gower cuts out, goes to Fatawira, steps inside Jones, steps around Fowler Mawina, who comes again with Villasanti to make the tackle. They're 40 yards from the line. Pritis goes to Campbell. Campbell puts the kick in. Farfili will drop back into the corner and watch it go over the touchline.
The Panthers are having a lot of success down this right-hand side, going at where Stacey Jones is playing one inside. Just seems to be some confusion there between him and Melly and the inside men. Sandy was coming to the sideline looking to be interchanged, but he's turned around and is heading back to the scrum with Lauatiti about to come into the game.
I don't know about you, Peter. I just get the feeling with the Warriors, and I might be wrong, but they just look like they're waiting for Penrith to burn out here. It looks as though they're prepared to let the Panthers get all this nervous energy out of their system, then come and get them. It's been a very relaxed, very conservative, very controlled start to the game. No panic despite the fact they're behind on the scoreboard, but they're not really trying anything at the moment.
It reminds me very much, Phil, of their first 20, 25 minutes against Canberra last week.
And here they are now, bringing the ball through the hands and getting it out to the 30-metre line. Again, they clear this danger area of theirs. This is Lauatiti playing in 15. And just a hand back for Webb, and there's that man I'm talking about, and there they go, the light feet of Webb. Down to the 40-metre line, Penrith's end of the ground. He's out of there like lightning, as Faumawina gives it away for the 5'8" Lulawai. He will play the ball 35 metres out from the line. Jones comes into it now. Then for Webb, and then it goes back to Lauatiti. It wasn't a good pass. He did well to handle it. Got the ball away for Anderson. Anderson beats one. He'll go all the way. Loses the ball. He was over and lost it, and Daniel Anderson, his namesake and coach, knew it.
And it came from absolutely nothing. They do back themselves this way. They'll just move it around. Webb will go through. Someone else will make a break. And here's Anderson. He's about to put the football down. Lewis has scored one. Now he's saved one.
A nervous coach sitting up in the grandstand there. You want to take those opportunities when they're presented. But you could feel that coming. You could just feel the Warriors waiting for their opportunity. And that's what they're like. They can strike from nowhere. Going back to what I said about being a conservative start, they won the toss here today and have elected to run into a fairly stiff breeze down there. It's like they just want to burn the Panthers out and then strike them when they drop off in intensity. It'll be up to the Panthers to concentrate.
So Girdler is taken out as Swain goes into the game in jumper number 17 for the Panthers, and Joe Nullivow is the man that comes off.
Which is quite a brave call, Gus, when you consider that the last performances we've seen of Penrith, they've actually, their intensity has got better as they've warmed into the game. So the opposition are looking for something different to happen to the way that we've normally seen Penrith operate.
Latua, 77 metres gained on only four hit-ups, so he's been monumental in that area. Here's Fafili fielding the high ball, coming back to the 30-metre line, linking up with Webb. There's a gap up the middle. Webb goes swerving around and around from the referee and then around behind the 5'8". Gets the ball away to Logan Swan. Swan down the right side and is tackled 32 metres goes out from the line. Play back to Fafili. Then to Webb. Now to Lulawai. Then it goes to Jones. Jones away to Lauatiti. Lauatiti then gets it on to Falmawina. And he is tackled 30 or 20 metres away from the Panthers' line. From Torpy, he goes to Jones. And Jones steps and then gets the ball away for Lauatiti. 8 metres off the goalposts. As Beetham goes to dummy half and Jones, Jinkson goes back in for Goodenbeel. Goodenbeel is tackled at the line just a couple of metres away. And then Beetham tries to charge over. Ball back to Lulawai. Lulawai back to Webb. Webb gets it back now for Corby. They're over the line. Beautiful ball movement. Logan Swan is in, is it?
It is Logan Swan.
Logan Swan has scored again in the finals.
That is the Warriors at their best. Bill Gould, spot on. Warming to their task, they back themselves. Look at the one-arm passes in this play. This is the fullback Webb making his second bust, going across field. He'll eventually link up with Logan Swan with an inside pass, and he makes a bit of a break as well. But it's just the enormous ability to offload to get their second phase play going that makes it so difficult for them to close down. Beetham had a shot. It wasn't on. Lulawai finds a support player in Webb. Webb steps back in, gets it into one hand, throws it to Corpu, keeps it in one hand, and off to Logan Swan. He got there first last week, he gets there first this afternoon.
So Logan Swan scoring the try. 4-4, we'll break, be back with you in just a moment. Well, this is the man that's been in the spotlight for taking his time. Kicking goals, Brent Webb. So we thought, well, rather than just stand back watching him get ready to kick, put the tee down, all the rest of it, we'll take our break between the try and the actual kick. Welcome back as Brent Webb has placed the ball on the tee. 15 in from the eastern side of the ground. He's a long way from ready.
Yes, Ray, time has already been called off by the referee, Tim Mander. Took 2 from 3 last week, over 100 points throughout his career. And we'll see Mander fairly shortly. Put the arm up, blow the whistle and tell the timekeeper to continue on.
Logan Swan scored the try. In reply to Luke Lewis's try for the Panthers. Girdler failed to convert the try from Lewis from wide out. And this is the 8th goal kicker this year, as Peter mentioned, that the Warriors have tried. And their goal kicking percentage is down around 60% between the 8 of them. Webb. And Webb into a commercial and come back. 20 out. 15 in. Come on, let's put some boot to ball. Time is back on. There's the kick from Webb, sailing around and missing. So 4 points all after 24 minutes.
It's very hard when you're a defender and a player runs at you with the ball in one hand. You don't know whether to take his body or try to reach for the football and stop its progress. And in this try, you get an example of what the Bulldogs had trouble with a couple of weeks ago. 3 in a row there. One-handed passes. They suck you in, but then you feel yourself groping at the ball trying to stop the pass. Very hard to defend to.
Kickoff time again. And Ali Lauatiti with a strong run. I know the New Zealanders have been waiting patiently for him to find some of last year's form.
He's a nice man to bring off the bench. Let's just have a look if any punch has gone out of this Panthers defence. That's 3 tackles now. Warriors are only 25 off their own line. Where will they be after 6?
Corpu. Reaching the 30-metre line. From Beetham then, it is with Goodenbeer. And that is tackle number 5, and they've made the 40-metre line. They've gone to their kicker now. Joe puts it down towards Wesser. Came off his hand. And Mander said knock backwards, and I think he got that call right.
It's an interesting one. He touches the ball and it's gone backwards.
It's okay. Mander got it right. And the Panthers are with it 35 metres out from their own line. 4 points all. A try apiece And both kickers failing to convert. Waterhouse gets ready in 15 to come on for the Penrith Panthers, the minor premiers.
Ben Ross is also out there in 14 for the Panthers as Girdler comes wide, throws the dummy, still offloads. That's Swain.
Brought down on the 30-metre line. The number 17 for Penrith. Now it's gone to Gow. And it's a high ball. Webb is under it. He left the field of play to go back into the in goal, according to Mander. It gave him a nice clear call. And he was right again there, the referee. Torpy has gone into dummy half, taking a little run.
Very bunched here, the Warriors. Everyone standing underneath the post, hands on hips, hands on heads. It's though they're very, very casual. There's an offload there that probably wasn't on. They're not working hard enough at coming out of trouble.
Melly then, and that is Falmawina, the locked forward. Nullavau back on the bench with Joel Clinton. As Wesser fields it back on his own 30-metre line. And Reese.
Marcus Square! No penalties in the middle.
Prolific try scorer at the back of the Penrith unit. Yet to get a real taste. This man has had a couple of tastes. Girdler to the 20-metre line. Campbell's come into dummy half, and Prittis orders him out of that area. He goes to the left, Prittis. Picks up Pulatua. Pulatua to the 10-metre line and pulled down. Now Campbell wants to have a go. He's a dummy half. It's gone to Gower. Gower to Sattler. Knocked on by Sattler. And it's a penalty to Penrith.
Tim Mander playing advantage.
I did, mate. That goes both ways.
It does.
Saying
you will get it both ways. Where you go?
Saying it goes both ways. Clinton Torby saying, I did get back, sir. The referee saying, no, you didn't. Decision to be made here. The Panthers feel as though there might be more than two on offer.
Ben Ross in 14.
Hold! What?
Takes the first play. Now it's with Prittis, and Prittis goes across to Waterhouse with fresh legs. Waterhouse is forced down. Where they are, right next to the uprights. As it comes from Prittis, it's gone to Gower. He steps off his left foot, then takes them on, gets it back to Sattler. Sattler shows them the ball, gives it to Swain. Swain is pulled down desperately by, I think it was Lauatiti. Now it's come away and gone past Fatawira. It's out to Luke Lewis. Lewis goes back towards the centre of the ground. Still going, crabbing across the ground. Tackled on the 10-metre line. Play back to Campbell. Campbell to Gower. Gower has a go himself, and Gower loses the ball. Picked up by Lauatiti, and he gets the ball away. Goodenbeel is with it for New Zealand.
They rolled the dice. They rolled the dice, the Panthers. They had a certain 2 points in front of the post. They decided to go for the try. I'm not against that, and it was exciting, but they've come up empty.
Fafili brought down around the bootlaces there by Luke Prittis has tackled. Here's Lauatiti.
They are really back to struggling, bring it out of their own end. They're going to kick from poor field position again unless Villasanti can do something here. That's the last, still inside their 30. A lot of pressure being put on Stacey Jones's kicking game.
Jones off his own 30-metre line. He puts it out on the full, so Penrith will have the loose head and feed. In fact, it'll be a turnover. Really came as a result of some very good defence from Penrith.
Well, it was the first time he had to kick left in this half of football. He prefers to kick down the right-hand side of the field, but his team got him in poor field position there. There was no yardage coming out of trouble, no structure to their play in their red zone. And as a result, he was under pressure, kicked it left, kicked it out on the full. Panthers on the attack.
This is Ross. Back up. 15 out from the uprights. They're going down the centre of the park. Sattler, Campbell, Wesser. 12 metres out from the line. Throws the pass badly behind Girdler. Gets gone over to Rooney. Rooney gave a dummy to Gower, then decided to go himself. And he will play it there, 12 metres out from the line at 4 points all. Campbell with a long ball out to Fatawira. He comes to Beetham and beats Beetham easily. Goes to Corpu, and Corpu and Villasanti make the tackle. The uprights are 7 metres away as Prittis goes back and finds Waterhouse. He goes back. Here's Wesser. Wesser's over. There's Penrith's second try. Reece Wesser is over. over. It is 8 points to four after 31 minutes.
And Reece Wesser from that distance is lethal. But give a big rap here to Trent Waterhouse. Off the bench, he's a good kid. Two defenders coming in, offloads. In fact, three went in. Richard Villasandy got interested. And by the time Wesser put the foot down, there was ample room for him to slide through. When you take this number 15, one of your priorities has got to be to stop the football. It's a good place to score.
You are playing with fire against the Panthers when you become lazy around the middle of the ruck. And let me say this, we were just talking about the Warriors struggling to work the ball out of trouble. I think it's complacency. I honestly think that the Warriors are taking the Panthers easily. I think that the Warriors believe they can score whenever they want to and are just waiting for the football back in good position. But you are playing with fire if you underestimate the Panthers, because they can look gone and then within a moment strike, as they have done here with Wesser underneath the post. They've done it all year. The Panthers have looked to be struggling. You feel as though you've got their measure, and all of a sudden, a Gower, a Waterhouse, or someone will hit the line, pop it back, and a Wesser, a Campbell, and a Prittis are on hand to take the football. The Warriors are playing with fire at the moment. If I was their coach, I couldn't wait to get him into the dressing room, put a rocket in him.
So Girdler converts. The Panthers go to a lead of 6 points. It is 10 points to four, the Panthers at the moment. Audience is taking us overseas, in the UK particularly today, through Sky Sports. We welcome you to our telecast. Reece Wesser's dad is having an enjoyable day. And as we bring you back to Nine's exclusive live coverage of this Sunday afternoon match, oh gee, that was very close to going over the dead ball line on the full. In fact, I'm almost sure it had Swain had his foot on the dead ball line, it would have been a penalty to Penrith back. You see what I'm saying? Had he have stood on the dead ball line, the ball would have come to him and they could have got a penalty at the middle of the halfway. It absolutely bemuses me why players aren't coached to stand on the dead ball line so they know exactly where they are. Here's Rooney now with the ball. Or Rodney, I should say, with the green headgear. Just inside the 40-metre line, and Sattler puts on a decoy run, and it's Waterhouse who's tackled. 4 or 5 metres short of halfway, Penrith leading by 10-4 as Gower goes across and picks up Girdler. Girdler's been very good today. He keeps opening them up down on that side. The ball, though, goes back into the hands of New Zealand. And it is with Anderson who plays the ball. Farfelli using Webb, and does a bit of dancing there before taking the tackle 30 yards.
Here's some great footwork there from both Craig Gower and Ryan Girdler. That's if you rush up on Craig Gower last tackle, he'll hurt you. And Villasandy did exactly that. Gower was good enough to find outside men. Girdler good enough to get away.
Lauatiti.
Last one!
Put down on the halfway line. Sydney Roosters there. They are there. Guaranteed a spot in the grand final next Sunday. These two are battling it out for the right to be there. Will it again be the Warriors? Will it be a replication of last year's grand final? Or will Penrith go there for the first time since 1991? Girdler having an outstanding game. He's opening up the right side defence for New Zealand. And he's done it a couple of times in the game so far. Here's Rodney in 16.
He can be very effective for them out wide. Also up the middle of the ruck, Prittis and Gower have both found space. Girdler's come in field and found lazy marker defenders and players around the ruck. Little nervous period here for the Warriors. Six behind. Only 4 minutes before the break. They can't afford another one now. Get too far behind on the scoreboard.
Oh, Ben Ross with a charge. And then he unloads the ball back to Torpy. Passes are being ill-directed.
Well, it's now a nervous time for Penrith, sorry, Ray. Because they're going to have to defend late in this first half.
No effect. He responded.
4 minutes to go as we look at the replay of what incurred the penalty, and it was, to my way of thinking, a dead set steal. Tim Mander getting it right. Beetham taking the tap, 35 away from the line. Villasanti for Jones, and Jones to Luluai, and then to Webb, and that might have been forward to Logan Swan, who loves to operate out wide. Here is Torpy on the 30-metre line looking for an opening. He's dealing with Swain at the moment, but Sattler and Swain and Ross, they prove too much for him inside the 30-metre line. Now it's with Jones, and Jones back to foul Marina, and he's going to be made to play the ball 30 metres out, or in fact 20 metres out from the Penrith line. Then from Mealy, it's gone across for Jones, and a short ball to Nowatini. Villasanti is over the line. Did he get the ball down? Referee Tim Mander wants to go to the video referee. Villasanti, I think that look on his face is one of lukewarm confidence. Let's have a look at it. Stretching.
Nah, it's try.
There's enough of it there for mine.
No doubt.
There's some lime on that football.
It'll be 10 all as we go to the break. He's short there, but momentum puts the point of the football onto the line. I've got no problem with that. There's a reverse angle shot, and that's the one that should confirm. He's still got his arm on the football. And good lead-up play once again. Stacey Jones, he's definitely taking the ball to the line more this afternoon. And their ability on the fringe of the ruck to get the pass away.
So we wait for the result to come down from Mick Stone and Eddie Ward. And it's a try to Richard Villasanti. Well, what a year he's had.
They run good lines here, Ray. They come straight. So he frees it there. Here's this man. He's actually coming back at the defence. And then there'll be support on the outside. Coming back, you expect left to right. They're coming right to left at you as play continues. And that's difficult. There he is coming back. All of a sudden, you've got to try and adjust your defence. And when players are coming at you at speed, it's difficult to make the tackle. Jones is so good at it. The short offload there to Lauatiti. You've got to go high on Lauatiti. Rodney Wetlow, you've really got to attack the football first and then worry about stopping the man second.
So Richard Villasanti picking up the try. It is 10 points to 8 in favour of the Panthers. Conversion from in front to come. Mander's whistle indicates time off again. Coming out of their 20-metre zone, they've looked sluggish, but we've said that a couple of times, and almost immediately they've replied with a try. There's the kick from Webb from right in front, and we are back at 10 points all now. Deadlock to 10 all, Andrew.
We now officially have a shot clock in rugby league. I'm going to defend Brett Webb here and the New Zealand Warriors. Tim Mander, after that try was awarded, or was just before he awarded the try, he said to the video referee Mick Stone quite clearly, tell me when it's 1 minute after I've blown the whistle to award the try, that is when I will stop the clock. Now, you've got to do it for all kickers. You can't just do it for Brent Webb.
Yeah, I'm with you, Voss. I don't think our players can be penalised, our kickers can be penalised for working for years and years and years to perfect something that works for them. But I'd be quite happy to see a clock brought in for 1 minute for every kicker. Do it for one, do it for all.
Here they go down the right side now. Tafili, and it's a penalty going to the Warriors. Jones, called on by his captain to find the line. And there's a minute left.
Yeah, which is time enough almost, Ray, you would think, for a full set of six. If they don't score a try, would they look for a field goal to take a one-point lead in?
Well, through the hands they went, and then it went to ground, and it's picked up by Webb. Six more tackles indicated by Tim Mander. The ball was played out. That's Vinnie Anderson to the 40-metre line. Gets it back to his centre partner. That is Clinton Torpy. Not often do you see centre throw the ball to centre, but it happened then. Torpy plays the ball back for Anderson. Anderson, it goes across to Jones. Jones to Villasanti, trying to roar up the middle. A handoff for Webb. Webb crosses the 30-metre line, puts a kick in. And Rooney has got the ball for Penrith.
Oh,
Idea was good, execution was poor from Brent Webb. He could see Luke Rooney getting interested, coming infield, and Fowler was on the outside. But didn't get there. Here's a kick from Craig Gower, looking for a 40-20.
And the ball crossing the line about 28 metres out, almost right in front of John Lang, the Penrith coach. That furrowed brow. And that is the halftime break. Well, 10 points all. People were talking about a toss of the coin deciding the result. People were talking about a high-scoring game. 10 points all. They have both scored two tries and kicked one goal. We'll come back for the second half of the preliminary final here at Telstra Stadium on the Wide World of Sports in just a moment.
The shadow starting to close over Telstra Stadium this Sunday afternoon. And the Warriors wrapped up at 10 points apiece. Two tries for the sides. Logan Swan and Richard Villasanti crossed for the Warriors. Whilst Penrith, Reece Wetzer and Luke Lewis got their four-pointers. And these sides now just 40 minutes away from a possible grand final appearance. That is, of course, if we don't go into extra time, into Golden Point, which may well be the case with the closeness of this game. Warriors taken back out by Monty Beetham. And there's no doubt that Daniel Anderson had plenty to say. Certainly laying down the law because he was not happy with their first 40 minutes this afternoon. A couple of stars, Craig Gower, been superb once again. 12 tackles, one line break, kicked intelligently, and a couple of offloads. And he'll continue to explore Richard Villasanti. A little bit of a knock early. The longer the game's gone, the better he has gone. 12 tackles, 7 hit-ups, just under 80 metres. And he did score a very important try under the posts to lock up this scoreline. Plenty to play for, nothing in it. Which side is going to hold on to the belief and take advantage of their opportunities?
So Ryan Girdler is waiting for Tim Mander to reach the centre of the ground. And he's done that now as he to Richard Villasanti. Scored the try just before half-time, did Villasanti, to bring them back to 10 points all. Tim Mander playing himself, really, for a grand final whistle. It's an interesting battle between Mander and Harrigan. Bill's basically been on the mantle for quite some time. As Villasanti kicks off. Second half of the match, and oh gee, referee Mander,
who's called a knock on,
has called it forward.
Was it not accidental offside or something here? You're saying it came off Luke Lewis and then on to.
I thought it was all right. I thought Waterhouse basically was the man that did all of that. Even if it went forward, he caught it before it hit the ground. But look, we've got to go with the decision at the moment. As the Warriors get a brilliant opportunity in the early part of the second half with Villasanti. 9 metres out from the line from Beetham. It's gone to Jones, back to Corpu. Corpu fends off the attempted tackle by Rodney. He's held by Ross. Has been played back to Beetham. Beetham away for Jones. Jones to Lauatiti. And Lauatiti lays it on the ground there for Vinny Anderson, and the Panthers will converge and they put him away. Trying to cover up this mistake that has blemished the start of the second half, Jones. Beetham this time. And now, went up from the back and puts a little kick in, and oh, gee, they almost went to sleep on it, the Panthers.
They did well there, Brent Webb. He realised Stacey Jones was tackled and was playing the football, so they needed another kicker. Got a checkered passage, and this was almost an air swing from Reece Wesser. Only just got it. Second attempt.
So this dropout is very, very short. Whether it was pre-planned, I'm not sure. The Kiwis, they batted back down to Villasanti. And he will play the ball just outside the 30-metre line, so the Panthers, from that kick, from that line dropout, they did okay, really. Fafili will play the ball now. That's where they are, just outside 20. Beetham off to the left for Jones, to the line, then to Lulawai, now to Webb, and here is Torpy. The ball goes to Melly and he puts it down. Kristen Campbell.
Well, that's a try bomb to the Warriors, and it may be just getting the Panthers over a little hump to a terrible start to this second half. They dropped the kickoff. They nearly conceded a try in the in goal. And look at Melly on the outside now. Torpy, he's got plenty of time to get the pass away. They wouldn't have stopped this fella. He'd have been too big and strong. But he dropped the ball.
Waterhouse now. It's almost as though Francis Melly had his game of football against the Dogs. What is it, 3 weekends ago now?
It's a terrible start to the second half by the Panthers. And that just may be a little bit of luck for them.
He loses the ball, Webb. And this is play on for Penrith. 31 metres out from the line as Campbell goes to Waterhouse. And the big fella, with probably the thoughts of that mistake still in his mind, takes it up to the 20-metre line, centre of the ground. Rodney runs to Villasanti and Corpu. 10 out from the line. There's a Warrior hurt. It's Villasanti. Now it's with Pridis. Then to Campbell. Campbell double pumps it. And Ross is tackled 2 metres out from the line. Play back to Prentice, and Prentice will go in. Luke Prentice is in. Third try of the day for the Panthers.
Well, what a crazy start to this second half. A mistake from the kickoff, which I'm still trying to work out the decision. We see the Warriors almost score at the other end. Brett Webb loses the football. And at the end of the set of six, Luke Prittis goes to the right-hand side, stays low after Ben Ross had gone very close the previous play. Marcus getting out too quickly, splitting. And Stacey James was never going to be able to stop Luke Prittis on his own from there. You've got to stay down low with the man, and you don't move until he's thrown the football. The most dangerous man on the field is the man with the football in his grasp, and that was Prittis.
Yeah, they overread it badly there. They were short on the left-hand side of the play, the ball. There was players out wide screaming for support. Here's the reverse angle. Prittis reads it. Lauatiti lazy. No concentration. Jones wasn't going to be able to stop him, and he got in low. And as I said, was that a little hump that the Panthers had to get over to? A nervous start to the second half, and all of a sudden, a couple of errors by the Warriors has brought them right back into it, and a try. We've got a ball game here, baby, I'm telling you.
14 to 10. Well, you're obviously not talking to me if you're calling me baby. There's the kick by Gerber converting. It's 16 to 10, the Panthers. Santi carrying the ball back to halfway, so he must have recovered. He was injured just before the try. Second preliminary final. Winner going through. As you come back, we're with the first tackle from the kickoff by Villasanti. It is Swain who plays it for Penrith, who now again lead 16 points to 10. The big lad with the ball, Waterhouse, though he's had a little blemish on his game, according to Tim Mander, he certainly had some very high moments in the game so far. Here's Prittis running with Ben Ross, riding shotgun for him, and then Sattler finds Wesser, and Wesser gets it away to Campbell. Desperate tackle by Beetham there. It had to be made. Now Gower, he kicks looking for Girdler, but Webb is there, and then he beats Gower, runs away from him, but Prittis takes him to ground. This is the offload from Wesser to Campbell. And really, Campbell was carrying baggage almost before he got the ball in the shape of Monty Beetham. There's Villasanti. He's made some indentations in the opposition. Not so much today, but in recent weeks, certainly. As the ball goes through a lot of sets of hands before Lulawai gets the ball.
This is good from the Panthers. They're really getting back on their line, putting the front leg up, pointing at their opposition and charging up to put some pressure on them. This is the best they've defended in this game so far.
Rodney making a superb tackle there on Vinnie Anderson. He made 5 or 6 metres for the Panthers without the football. Webb gets it away for foul. Mawina, who's able to beat Fatawira, then gets the ball around the corner and the ball is loose. Campbell's got the ball. It's gone both ways, according to Tim Mander.
Well, they make some of the most childish mistakes in a game you will ever see, the Warriors. The thing is about them, they can hurt you with the most sublime bit of football in the next moment. That was the last tackle. Nothing happened. It was the end of a very poor set of six and a lot of pressure from the opposition in defence. And now Penrith. And they hurt them even more. Waterhouse has been strong, but that's going to be a mistake.
That's going to be a knock-on, I would imagine, against Penrith.
That is just the one you didn't want. You know, there's moments in football games where you've just got to get it right. And this was one of those moments. They had the Warriors on the rack. And you can't criticise him because that's the way he's played all year. He's always looked to get the second phase play. But the head goes down. He says, look, if only once I'd have thought about holding on to it. It was out there before. Oh, can I just have it back, please?
No starts, Reese. It's out.
So Webb is inundated by defence from Swain and Campbell. And now Lauatiti. Taken by Swain and Sattler that time. Webb waits for a runner and finds Falmawina. And he gets a one-hander away for Webb. Webb works off his 40-metre line. Knocked on by Lewis. It's come back for New Zealand, but it's a penalty going to the Warriors.
Yeah, it's also a very big penalty for the Warriors. They're starting to lose ground every now and then with the football. I still thought they were turning it past that ball.
Everyone on the ground thought he passed it. He was back there playing and everyone was downfield playing on.
Tap. Here's Pagliacina into the game now.
Well, that's a surprising first touch as well. Not.
Now, Jerry, see you, see you. As Villasanti gets some attention back on the bench. From Jones to Lulawai. Lulawai tries to break them himself. And he's rolled over onto his back there. And a good tackle by Luke Pritis. Played back to Logan Swan. Then for Stacey Jones. Now for Pagliacina. 10 out. Right in front of the uprights. Running towards the southern end. Beaten away for Jones. Jones out for Falmawina.
The back one.
Struggles to play the ball quickly. Then Beetham goes back to a second man and Jones goes looking for Farfile. And I fancy that it's coming out to the 20 for the restart.
Strange play there. Strange play. I don't think Farfile was expecting the crossfield kick. He may have expected a grubber kick into the end goal. I would have liked to see them run it there. But here's some good defence now from the Warriors as they try to surge back into the game.
So there's a bit of a dust-up erupting now.
Yeah, Pagliacina seemed to give a face massage to Ben Ross. A couple of Penrith players going back onside took exception.
Yeah, get a look at it, Dan. We're going to take our time here. We're going to take our time here. Ben, over here. Ifeeda, over there. Yeah, that's what I'll go for that. OK, Ben. When you make that tackle, that was a very good dominant tackle, okay? But you can't touch that head. I want you away from the face altogether. And Ben, you let me look after it, okay? No one else. The penalty's against you for the extra work and the tackle afterwards, okay? That's it.
So the Warriors penalised for the tackle by Pagliacina on Ross.
I think I would recommend to young Ross that if you're going to start a fight or get involved in a fight, on your back, on the ground, under Pagliacina is not the place to start it from.
Hold here.
Campbell then, for Sway. And look at this tackling now from the Warriors as they build up in aggression. They build up in domination of the tackles. Pull a two now. 5 or 6 metres onto Warriors turf, and it's with Pritis who's come really into the game in the second half. He's making A lot of dummy half work, a lot of dummy half runs. Wesser, Campbell, Gower, Sattler. And again to the ground 20 metres out. Good work by the Panthers, nice ball movement. Then for Gower, and he goes high and he goes across towards Fafili's wing. Oh, Rooney, that might be play on. I think this might be a try for Girdlove. It seemed to come off his legs. That is not a knock on. Did it go back off the wing of Rooney? If it did, I think it's come off Girdlove's legs and it will be a try.
That's the only concern, Ray, did the ball go back? There's no knock on from that man, Ryan Girdler. It definitely hit his legs.
Luke, a kick, Peter.
Yeah, onside. Luke Rooney, very good under the high ball. In fact, all four wingers out there this afternoon are. But Rooney, he's just grabbed it, realised it's the last tackle. He's got to get it back. And I think it has gone back. The hands are away from the football. Girdler, great presence of mind to realise, don't knock on this, keep it on the toe. That's a try.
Well, the thing about it is he hasn't dropped it, he's passed it. And the video referee cannot rule on a forward pass. He catches it, and it will be a passing motion. It's a passing motion, therefore it cannot be a knock-on ruled on by the video referee. Girdler does well. Composure. Class there. In a tight game, an important moment.
Green lights in the background over the frame of John Lang. And the Panthers now looking comfortable at 20-10. 52nd minute replay again.
Well, I don't think you ever feel comfortable against the Warriors. But, gee, it's a good lead. Only half an hour out from a possible grand final appearance. And this is, it's just wonderful play. Firstly from Rooney to get the football. And Girdler, he just kept his head. He knew what was required. Would have been easy to knock that on in a couple of different instances. Didn't do so.
So 20 to 10, the Panthers leading now. Girdler. Lining this up. From 8 metres in, 25 out. And he gets it. And 20 points to 10, the Panthers. Conversion attempt for Ryan Girdler, strikes it, and it is there. So the Panthers boot out to 22-10 now. 54th minute. Webb. Nullavell.
Well, you've got to hold on to your hats now, because a 12-point deficit is an invitation now to the Warriors to throw absolutely everything they've got in their attacking armory at the Panthers. They've lived by the sword that I, they're dying by it, but they're a chance of getting themselves out of it. That's just the sort of team they are.
Yeah, no surprise. They put Modu Toney out there now, and he was the catalyst against them, against the Bulldogs. Actually scored two or three tries when they had 12 men on the field. And he sparked them. I agree. I think that they are even more dangerous now that they are forced to play football.
Gower's kick bouncing up for Francis Melli. It comes to Campbell. The line is down on him. The defensive line. Fafili.
Up by one. Square up, Marcus.
22 metres out from his own line as Vinnie Anderson lays the ball back for Francis Melli, who reaches the 30-metre line as we go to the sideline. Andrew.
Well, I will tell you one thing, Ray. Daniel Anderson, the Warriors coach, will be filthy with what has transpired in the 14 minutes since halftime. Two of the key points at halftime, what he told his players. One was to watch out for Luke Prittis. He thought he was making too many metres. Luke Prittis comes up with a soft try from dummy half. Second, talked about field position for an Afita Paliasina to give the Panthers a piggyback out of trouble just a minute before that try was scored. They are two things that just fly in the face of what Daniel Anderson said to his players at halftime.
Balmawina to play the ball close to halfway. It's back to Jones, and Jones's kick will go straight to Reece Wesser. Bounces off the chest originally, but he comes out towards the 30-metre point.
On the other hand, too, I mean, if the Panthers have got a 12-point break and there's a little bit of nerves out of their system, they've got the ability to pile on a couple themselves. They're in a real dangerous position here, the Warriors. I think complacency's got them into this. They're going to have to fire up to get out of it, but their forwards aren't getting over the advantage line. The Panthers are defending much better.
Now, the 14 is Modu Toney. I believe the ball was knocked on by the tackler. And that's the way Tim Mander was ruled. So it'll be a Penrith loose head and feed.
Okay, let's get our formation right, boys. This way. Okay, where we go?
Gower comes to the left for Girdler. And Girdler puts a fend on and then runs dangerously close to the sideline here on the western side of the Olympic Stadium. It's with Rooney now, the winger, who together with Girdler found that last try for them. Pridis passes for Clinton. And Clinton, now there's a Shepherd. It's a penalty to the Warriors.
Bad luck there for Joel Clinton. He was really revving up to get his team on the front foot. Ran into the back of a teammate. It did give him some slight advantage. It was Sattler that had gone through as a decoy. Joel, get out of my way. I've got enough to worry about with the Warriors without you in my way. He gives away a penalty.
Jones finding the line at the junction of the halfway. Pagliacino winds it up and lets it hang out. Down to the 40-meter line. Beetham goes behind two, finds Joe, finds Webb. Webb, 33 metres out. A little bit better than that. Going down the eastern side of the ground. Jones for CU now. Big, big trouble brewing. Interchange, 7 for Penrith, 6 for the Warriors. The Warriors, 12 in the rears. Pagliacino, Beetham wasn't alert. CU, then Webb, cut out ball over to Torpy. Lewis had come off his wing. He had to make that tackle. 25 out from the line. Melly is with the ball. He's running an arc, but he's running into defence, and he tries to go through, but they put him away.
Last one. No penalties.
29 metres out from the line. Jones for Motu Tony. Tony is away. He beat Gower. He comes to Wessa. Loses the ball. No, he doesn't. It goes back to Jones to Torpy. Oh, that is brilliant. Did he get the ball down? Did he get the ball down?
We've got Luke Pridis and Penny Torpy going hammer and tongs. I hope he's got it down to the extent that the pass from Motu Tony deserved to lead to a try. And then the one from, I think, Stacey Jones.
We're going to wait. We're going to wait for this.
This is the put down.
Oh, yeah, it's down.
He put it down 10 minutes ago.
Who's that?
This might be an 8-point try.
Well, no, I
think Torpy threw the first one.
Although, yeah, I think there was an accidental touch from Luke Pridis, which Torpy misconstrued and then threw a punch.
Here at the moment. Just wait.
Have a look at Luke Pridis here. He just gets a touch.
Here we go. Wait.
Torpy reacts really against nothing. I think it's just a try and play on, kids.
You scored the try and you carried on with it. Okay, now listen. Don't think just because you scored a try and it's open slow that you can do what you want. Okay, that's totally unnecessary. And Luke, don't take it in your own hands. We'll look after it. Okay, now listen. We've got a great game here. Little things like that are going to cause penalties and could sway the game. Wait for a moment. Let's keep control of ourselves, and that is totally unnecessary. The try's been scored, there's no problems there. Keep your hands to yourself. Okay, let's go.
So you're saying, Tim, you can punch on up
the end of the It was minor.
The exchange between Tony... Well, there's the try being awarded officially. There's no problems there. If you're a Warrior supporter, you've got yourself 4 points. Let's go through it, though. This last exchange between Jones and Tony is most interesting. Tony.
Don't forget, this is last tackle, and again, it's come from nothing. The pass and that one, just top draw. Now, a huge kick coming up for Brent Webb.
Well, just for a moment, I thought Tony might have lost the ball, but no, he intentionally passed it, and then Jones somehow or other found Torpy out. Then all of that. So it is 22 points to 14 in favour of the Panthers now. calling timeout. We're just taking a break here locally. As we come back, 22-14, a chance for Brent Webb to bring it back to a 6-point ball game. They are both desperate for a grand final berth. Webb is 20 out. He's 12 in from touch. And this one he hits, and hits it just across the face of the uprights. So it is 8 points the margin. 1 hour of the game is gone.
And the Warriors, they're like a bunny chasing a rabbit at the moment. They're 12 down, now 8 down on the scoreboard. Tony is able to pull through some defence. Watch this pass, without looking, back on the inside. Jones to the outside, saw the cover defence coming. Beautiful try there. But they're chasing a rabbit here, a greyhound chasing a rabbit. They've got a lead to catch. 25 minutes to score 10 points to get in the grand final.
We had a bunny chasing a rabbit. Here's Brent Webb getting involved now. That's good. Field position there after a couple of rucks, and Pagliacina improves it over halfway.
Bunnies do chase rabbits too.
Penalty goes to Penrith. He's penalised the Warrior for not getting up and playing the ball. Pagliacina again is at the centre of the penalty. You must rise with the football and play the ball.
And those little attentions to detail, those little lacks of discipline are the things that are hurting the Warriors at the moment. They're causes for frustration. 20 left in the game. We're down to the championship rounds. You're 8 down on the scoreboard. You don't want that frustration in your game. You don't want to invite this team into your territory to extend the lead.
So Luke Prittis away for Craig Gow.
Up by one.
28 metres out from the Warriors' line.
You're doing that, Craig.
And Penrith cuddling this 8-point lead at the moment. Clinton is with the ball. They've played 3 times this year, including a trial match at Invercargill. And Penrith have beaten them 3 from 3. Prittis to Campbell. Campbell to Sattler. Sattler dummies to Nullavell. Finds Fatawira. He gives it to Wessa. Wessa then decides to try and circle the troops if he can. Then he finds an opening and tries to go through it. 19 out from the line. Already he has scored 1 try in the game so far. Sattler for Lang, and Lang is tackled 10 away from the line. Well, a converted try here would just about seal it. Nullavell has scored! Penrith are over again. 26-14. Girdler will attempt conversion.
You asked Joe Nullavell whether he liked having the week off. He's a guy who couldn't walk from the field against Brisbane, and now he's done what he's done all season. Busted into people, come out the other side, slams the football down. He's been very instrumental in the good things that have happened at Penrith this year, and he's brushed through Torpy and Jones to maybe score the match winner.
It's just power, it's desire, it's strength. He just surges onto this. Lines himself up with the little man, Stacey Jones. Pulls out the other side. And the Warriors, well, they're dying by the sword today. They're dying by their own mistakes. They've invited this brilliant attacking football team, this young, enthusiastic team from the foot of the mountains. They keep inviting them down this end of the field, and the Panthers are hurting them.
And as Vossi pointed out, Pagliacina's had a couple of unfortunate touches the last few minutes, as we see the stats there for Joe Nullavell. Firstly, they had the football at the other end of the field. I'm sorry, no, it didn't. Came up with some good defence, a bit of a face massage. The opposition scored just after, and now he's been penalised for not playing the football properly. They score in the next set of 6.
So, one of Penrith's heroes, Ryan Girdler, from 12 in from touch, and that looks good. Flags are up. And the hopes of the Panthers are up as well. 28 points to 14. Again, we watch Joe Nullivow. Andrew Voss.
Oh, this is massive, isn't it? 16 half minutes to go. You're 14 in front, and you're still as nervous as you can possibly be. Listen, Tim Mander, by the way, did blow time off for Ryan Girdler then. After 1 minute, the scoreboard clock didn't pick it up. He had two attempts. They still didn't pick it up. So there's a bit of having to square the ledger work there to be done by the timekeeper.
Here is Pulatua now. He'll be keen to go blow for blow with Joe Nullivow. It's been the essay that they've set each other. Here is Lang.
I was talking to Coach John Lang a few weeks ago, and he spoke about times with the Sharks when they've come into semi-finals. He said there was a couple of years there where we held 12 and 14 point leads, and we tried to protect our lead. He said, if there's one thing I can give to the Panthers from experience, if we get to the front, keep playing football.
Well, Gus, that man there was in charge in 1999 when Cronulla finished minor premiers and they failed to go through to the grand final. As that kick is knocked on by Francis Melly, so too by Joe Nullivow. It'll be knock-ons both ways, but a Penrith feed.
There's no doubt about that. Francis Melly has made the mistake first.
And some heads have gone down here in the Warriors side. They've looked up at the scoreboard, they've looked at the clock, they've seen the error. They've thought, gee, this might be getting beyond us here. They've got to start thinking about holding the Panthers out, and they can't do it.
That's the captain in the foreground. There's no joy on the bench. There's no joy on the scoreboard. As Campbell goes across to Wesser. Wesser just holds it back and then tries to beat them himself.
Oh, one, let it go!
Oh. And Girdler finds himself at acting half, 12 metres out from the line. Campbell running an angle for Sattler to come back towards the blind side. Girdler, is Girdler thinking about drop goal? He was just pointing to the uprights to his captain, Gow.
No, Ray, that's not the play now. The scoreline doesn't suggest they need a field goal.
Curtis's pass has gone to the Warriors now.
Warriors ball.
Yeah, Warriors ball. You just see there the man being pushed back, playing the football. Martin Lang interfered with Luke Curtis. Now Atiti, he shows some urgency to get there.
Good and Beal and Tafili. And it's a penalty going to the Warriors. It's against the markers.
Let's take stock here. 14 minutes in front. 14 points in front, 14 minutes on the scoreboard. Not beyond the Warriors. But the Panthers, you would think, with a chance to get through to the decider, could muscle up enough defence here on these big fellas and hold them out.
Well, one thing in their favour, Gus, is their last three games coming into this one, they've only conceded one second-half try, which is quite remarkable. And they've only conceded one second-half here as well. So they are defending beautifully, although Melly...
Melly has found an opening. They've got support. Here they come, the Warriors. They're over. The fullback is in, Brent Webb. Right under the crossbar. And it's not over yet, Peter.
Nah, that just shows. Forget statistics. Don't worry about statistics. Doesn't matter what they've done the last three games. What they're doing now is up against a desperate football team who is going to ask questions, and Francis Melly, who's had a fairly unfortunate afternoon, comes up with a good step around Joe Nullivow. Look at the support. He's got Torpy on the far side, Webb on this side. Four's about to become six. It isn't over.
14 in 14 minutes is now going to become 8 in about 12 minutes. And I think that this young man will have the quickest conversion kick of his life. Have a look at this. He doesn't need to take 3 minutes for a kick. He's ready in 22.1 seconds. World record, personal best, 2 points.
It's a PB for Brent Webb. But what scintillating attack it was. Francis Melly, I thought he might have left his best run about 3 weeks ago. He's made a magnificent break, and then the lightning feet of Brent Webb has taken them to 28-20 down. Twelve minutes to go. And the Panthers taking their time.
Can you imagine what's going through John Lang's head down there on the sideline? Can you imagine what he's thinking down there on the sideline? He's trying not to look at the clock. He's trying not to look at the scoreboard. His eyes will be flicking along his defensive line, looking for someone who's tired. Can I get someone on there that can help us? Can we hold on? What's going through that mind?
Here is Fafini. Never mind about asking us, can we imagine? You've been there. You've done that. You've been trampolining and all of that. Foul Mawina plays the ball back for Torpy, who hits CUCU with the pass. And now they are 35 metres out on five. Webber dummy half. Jones at receiver. Jones to the air. It's a big kick. Fafina's got a big jump on him, but not as big as Rooney.
Yeah, well done, son. Never took his eyes off the ball. Farfouli is a great leaper himself, but Rooney's out-jumped him twice today. Two big takes. Nullivau comes from the field.
Great to see a youngster attempt something where there was a possible mistake. He didn't hang back. There's Nullivau limping off with what you would think would be a recurrence of that hip injury. Rooney could have easily made a mistake there if he hadn't been positive. He didn't stay back.
And it was Nullivau who missed the tackle on Melly when he went through for that try. So John Lang is flicking his eyes across the defensive line. Who can he get out there that can make some tackles, or more importantly, won't miss tackles?
Pritis puts in a kick that is a very good one because it's gone deep and it's coming back off their line with Brent Webb, and he takes on Swain and Pritis and Fatawira. And now Melly uses Farfili, winger to winger. And Farfili goes back over to the left side of the ground. Beetham, the captain, gets ready to come back into the game. That is Corpu. Matt John, sideline.
Yeah, Gus touched on it before, boys. It is a long 10 minutes coming up for the Panthers. It's a big mental challenge for him. You just got to find a way to forget about the scoreboard, because it is very, very difficult to protect a lead this far out when you're playing conservative.
So the timepiece showing 9.5 to go. Reece Wesser brings it back to almost the 30-metre line.
The key for the Panthers is they've got to complete sets of six. If there's only 9 minutes left on the scoreboard, they've got to make sure they at least control possession for 4.5 minutes of that. They've got to get their 50% share, and they can't give it back cheaply. If they can get to their sixth tackle every time, they should be sweet.
Swain playing it. And now it's Lang, who's met by Falmawina and Beetham and Clinton. Back on the bench as they run away from their 40-metre line for Waterhouse.
Last one! Back up.
Campbell to Gower to right foot. Gower's been put on his back. I didn't see any illegality there. Tim Mander's okay. Touch judges have said nothing. Here's Melly.
Right. Short side, all the way!
Was the kick.
Right, go left!
There's nothing in there. He couldn't pull out of it, and he did nothing malicious.
Back up.
He'll be back up on his feet, and that is the first assignment completed by Penrith. They got through to the end of the set of six. Now they've got to defend Torpy.
Here's Torpy, Peter! Raises the hopes of the Warriors every time he touches the ball. To a lesser extent, so does that man. Falmawina, scooped off the ground by Torpy. It is now with Guttenbeel. And how do you play at 40 metres out? On the fourth tackle in the centre of the ground. Jones takes them on and he runs at Pulatua. Reaches the 30-metre line. Lang got involved in the tackle. Beetham gives it on. Webb with Campbell. Flick pass, then Guttenbeel. He kicks and it's gone down in behind Rooney, who'll be made to field the ball and bring it out of the end goal. Fafili loses his footing and Tony is there to make the tackle with Villasanti.
The problem there was that Stacey Jones was tackled on tackle five. Webb got it, but Preston Campbell got on him quickly, flicked it back to Guttenbeel, a hurried kick, not the one that the Warriors wanted. They wanted a kick where they could get a chance of getting the ball back.
Just inside the 30-metre line, Penrith end of the ground, the Panthers, the hope of the Golden West of Sydney, leading by 8 points. And they are 7.25 minutes away. Grand final feeling.
Whoa.
And a Penrith penalty will help.
I'll be keen to have a look at this. He was in good position to call on this, Tim Mander, but no,
that's not a penalty.
No, it's not. Not in the context of this game, or any game.
That's not a penalty. Gee whiz, that is a... That's a bad decision.
So is the clock.
starts here, Richard.
Ticks down.
No,
we are just seconds closer to an All Sydney Grand Final. That ball is lost. That ball is lost by Sway.
They had no control. And no control.
And we'll put a scrum down 20 metres out from the line.
That's what I was saying. That's what they don't want. They don't want an error. There was a little hand in there. The Warriors have got to start to gamble on that to try and force errors, and they've got one away here. Been able to rip away at that ball. Swain appeals to the referee. He hasn't seen it. And all of a sudden, the Warriors get a scrum feet. You've got to get your six out of the ball.
So the Warriors trailing by eight. And their opportunities. Five and a half minutes, or maybe 6 minutes to go. Their opportunities are now reduced. And they might only get another.
Oh, Marcus Square, Marcus Square.
Five opportunities if things swing with the pendulum evenly. Played by Gooden Beal. Now Tony.
Are there any chances to get a repeat set somehow? They need to. They come up with a great kick or a mistake from the opposition, a penalty, something.
Lauatiti did well. Jones got it away. Tony on the bounce.
Okay, last one.
Tony near the halfway line. Plays it back to Beetham. Now it's to Jones. Floats out the ball. It's gone out to Vinny Anderson. He gets it on the inside to Villasanti. Yes.
The ball on the ground. Oh, great tackle there from Ryan Girdler.
Turnover.
They're always going to run it. That stage, they didn't really have much choice. They were still around the halfway line, but Girdler stayed with Villasanti on the inside and nabbed him straight away.
Under five to go, Rabbits. They only need to complete two sets of six here, the Panthers. If they can complete two sets of six, they're in the grand final. They just don't want to drop ball now.
What a half.
On three, square up, Marcus.
Campbell sends it to the blind side. For Swain. And pull it to her. He's back to the benches. Ross is about to go back into the game. It's with Gower. He floats the ball over to Rooney. Rooney's got Rodney on his inside. He's got Wesser to choose from. He's with Campbell now. Campbell goes over to the 40-meter line, picks up Sattler. Sattler lays it back for Waterhouse. He comes to the centre. Torpy, the ball goes away to Fatawira now. This is Fatawira taken down by Gooden Beal and Beetham.
Well, they ate up some time on that play. That went east-west.
Pritis for Gower. Gower puts the kick down towards Francis Melly's corner. Melly outside the 10.
Unless something freakish happens here.
That's fine.
John
That's
Lang
fine.
And Peter Mulholland look on very anxiously That's and nervously. An incredible feeling about to come over some of these Penrith players when the final whistle goes. Only one of them have experienced a first-grade grand final. That was Luke Pritis for Brisbane.
That's right.
And the relief that they are going to feel after the huge expectation and pressure they've experienced for weeks now. Of course, they'll have to regather to prepare for next week. That is if the Warriors can't come up with something.
Last one.
Quite incredible in the last minute or so.
3 minutes to go now. Warriors with Webb, and it's gone into touch.
It's over. It's over. Panther fans, you can rise up now. You're going to the big show. The Panthers are in the grand final. Less than 3 minutes left on the clock. 8 points in front. And they've done it as they've done it all year, with tremendous attacking football, taking their chances.
Back it up.
See John Lang their mouth. One more. Just one more.
Rodney's made a break up the middle. Webb makes the tackle. Penrith are 20 metres out. Some unfinished business. Sattler away for Girdler. Puts the kick in. Taken by Tony.
I guarantee you, Ryan Girdler's not looking at the clock. He wouldn't care what time it was. He doesn't care what day it is.
I tell you what, hasn't he risen, though, to the occasion?
He's been the best player on the field for mine.
Hasn't he risen to the big time and met the challenge? Now it's from Anderson over to Jones, and Jones to Lauatiti. Then it's out to Webb.
Stand up.
Under 2 minutes to go, Penrith to their first grand final since they won it back in 1991. 28-20, doing to the Warriors what they've done consistently all year, and that is to rack up a win. Three times they've played, three times they've beaten them, if you include the trial match. Whistler to play the ball.
Well, the Warriors lost this in the first half for mine. I don't know whether it was laziness or complacency, but they definitely didn't come with the type of firebrand. Here we go, Martin Lang, get up son, run.
Rooney's coming up on his inside. Lang doesn't see him, does a complete 360. The loudest cheers were coming from his father. Wesser puts it down, and the Warriors come up with the football. Francis Melli away from Rodney, away from Waterhouse. No, he's not. Waterhouse made the tackle. Played back to Beetham. Then it's gone to Falmawina. This is Farfili. Not going anywhere. Back to Pagliacina. Pagliacina looking to unload and is pulled down by Rodney and Swade. Now Lauatiti held on the 40-metre line and driven into the ground. Again, Rodney making the tackle. Then it's Torpy. The ball may have been touched by Penrith. They've come back with the ball, though. Was there an advantage for the Warriors? Rodney's with the ball now.
Well, the advantage was that Clinton Torpy flicked it out the back and it went straight to Rodney. All academic now. Luke Prittis, fitting that he's going to get the ball away to Preston Campbell. And that will be it.
Siren in the background. The second preliminary final is over, and it's been won by Penrith, defeating the New Zealand Warriors 28-20.